Warm greetings to the gentlemen and ladies sitting over there and watching this video. This is Deepika, happily welcoming you all to Pritya Classroom. So in today's video, we are about to see next scenario on problems on train. Yes, in the last video, we have seen how to deal with the problems on train where a train is crossing a bridge or a tunnel or a platform. So in today's class, we are moving on for the next scenario where we are having two parallel railway lines just like this. Two parallel railway tracks, and here you could see two trains, blue train and green train, are traveling in the same direction. Okay, so if we are provided with this kind of scenario, how to deal with this? So as we know, basically we need to know what are the changes that we require to do in three parameters according to the scenario given. So talking about the scenario, this train has a length of L1 and this train has speed H1, and the green color one, second train, which has the L2 as its length and speed as S2. Okay, so if this is the case, then what happens to the distance parameter, then what happens to the speed parameter, and what happens to the time parameter? Let's see it one by one. So here both the objects, both the trains have some certain length. So basically, whether we need to add up the length or we need to subtract the length. So this is the first question that we need to solve. Okay. So, but before that, I would like to tell you one thing. So if you have traveled in train, you would have experienced it. So say, for example, if you're sitting in this train and if some train is crossing you, you might feel sometimes as if you are still, like as if your train is not at all moving, but still your train will be moving in the same direction as before. Why? Because whenever two train crosses along the same direction, relative speed will be less. Okay, so you will feel the speed of, like, if your train is speeding with if your train is traveling with the speed of 800 km per hour, if suddenly if your some train is crossing your train, which is also traveling in the same direction with a speed of around 95 km per hour, then you will experience only 5 km per hour, and that makes you to feel as if your train is moving slowly, or sometimes you may feel as if your train has stopped moving. Okay. Okay, so with keeping this in mind, let's solve the problems. Okay, so talking about the speed is going to be the difference in between the speed of two trains. Okay, so basically we will not call it as speed, we'll call it as relative speed. Okay, and the time is nothing but the time taken by the trains to cross each other. Okay, and now coming to the length. So train one has a length of L1. And the train 2 has the length of L2. So basically, you have to add the length. Why? Because both the train has to cross their lengths. So you have to add the length. Okay, so I'll just summarize whatever we have seen so far. Whenever you are given with a scenario where the two trains are crossing each other in the same direction, then you have to add up the lengths for distance. You have to find the difference in the speed for the speed, and the time is nothing but the time taken by the trains to cross each other. Okay, let's see with some example problem. Two trains 100 meters and 200 meters long are running in the same direction with the speeds of 72 km per hour and 54 km per hour. In how much time will the first train cross the second? Okay, so let's write down what are given points. Like, as we know, the distance is nothing but the sum of two trains' length. The first train is of 100 and second train is of 200. So it is very simple and easy. 300 meter. And now, speed. Speed of one train is 72 kilometer per hour and another train is 54 kilometer per hour. As we know, we need to find the difference in between these two trains. We have to subtract them. So on subtracting, we will get 18 kilometer per hour. Okay, so the relative speed is 18 kilometer per hour. And how long will the first train to train take to cross the second one? So basically, we need to find the time. So what is the formula for finding time? Time is equal to distance by speed. Speed is equal to distance by time, and time is equal to distance by speed. And before proceeding, we need to check for units. As you can see, one is in meter and another one is kilometer per hour. So what we are going to do, we are just going to convert kilometer per hour into meter per second, and it is very easy. We just want to multiply it by 5 by 18. Very good. So as we multiply, we don't want to simplify the expression here itself, because after substitution, we may get a chance to cancel. Okay, so let's substitute the values over here. And as you know, the distance is 300 meter and the speed is 18 multiplied by 15 by 18. So denominator of denominator will always go to numerator. So let's write this 5 by 18 in the numerator. 18 in the numerator. And let's cancel 18 and 18. So 15 one times, and this is 20. So the answer is 20 seconds. So here is the gift for you. Okay, so this problem is very similar to the problem that we solved now. So try doing this on your own and comment below your answers. If you have any doubts, you can just comment in the box. And if you feel this video will be helpful for someone who is preparing for competitive exams, or who is reading some aptitude book, or like if they are in need of it, please feel free to share and subscribe to support me. Thanks for watching this video. Bye bye.